Ah, I bet you didn't think you'd be seeing us again until the big day itself. Well, that might have been the case if we hadn't encountered a certain film that we thought all of you needed to know about. Noroi, which translates to The Curse, was directed by Koji Shiraishi and co-written by Shiraishi and Naoyuki Yokota. You might remember that this duo contributed to the anthology Dark Tales of Japan, which we covered earlier this month. In fact, it was that collection that led us to discover Noroi, and boy, what a discovery it was.
The film was released in 2005 amidst the boom of J-horror, during which popular horror films from Japan were imported and remade en masse in the West. This is the time period in which we received adaptations of what might now be considered modern classics like Ringu and Ju-on. Some Japanese directors even made the jump to working in Hollywood, like Takashi Shimizu, who remade his own Grudge films, or Masayuki Ochiai, who, oddly enough, remade the Thai horror film Shudder in 2008 under the Hollywood system. The rules were being made up as films were produced, with studios and distributors alike clamoring to grab any film rights they could. It was like the Wild West of Japanese horror flowing into Western cinema, and, unfortunately, some films were buried under the bigger names. Starting today, we'd like to do what we can to rectify those forgotten gems of the era by introducing new audiences to them as we uncover more. Tomorrow, we're going to be dissecting a heavy hitter, and judging by the number of requests we've received for it, it's safe to say a lot of you have probably seen it. Noroi, on the other hand, is the perfect film for anyone looking for a fantastic horror movie that you probably haven't already seen, come Halloween proper.
Noroi's story is a deceptively simple one. It follows a paranormal investigator, Masafumi Kobayashi, during the filming of his final documentary. But this isn't a spoiler, as right from the get-go, we're presented with a framing device which places Kobayashi firmly in a position where his use of a camera is both reasonable and logical. It also explains away the fact that we're viewing a well-edited documentary film, thus allowing us to begin to fall into the documentary and believe the characters. Naturally, this also leads us to understanding why the film is presented as it is, effectively telling us what point A and point B are in this narrative, and making us wonder how Kobayashi and company will travel between the two. This is immensely important because as a result of these small touches, Noroi effectively engages the audience in a way in which modern found footage films seem to struggle.
As the film progresses, this indoctrination of the viewer into believing the fictional world extends to the plot. We're along for the ride, more or less becoming the cameraman. He's referenced at multiple points as we intrude on the lives of various Tokyo residents, and knowing nods are given to the camera. But it's never played for laughs. Instead, minor characters react the way real people might when presented with cameras unexpectedly. We thus fall further down the rabbit hole, following Kobayashi on his journey. This is perhaps the biggest thing that sets Noroi apart from many found footage films of the past decade or so, where most of them, perhaps inspired by Paranormal Activity and its sequels, won't do much to move beyond the confines of a single location. Noroi keeps going and going, the characters moving wherever they need in order to unravel a set of mysteries that seem separate, but which may have some bearing on one another.
This is another important distinction. Noroi has a simply massive cast compared to many popular found footage films. Instead of focusing on a single family and perhaps a neighbor or two, we follow the disparate plot threads revolving around Kobayashi's personal life, a young woman who supposedly has ESP, an up-and-coming celebrity, a literal tinfoil hat conspiracy theorist, plus a mother and son who seem like the best neighbors you could possibly hope for. Noroi weaves a labyrinthian mystery using these various characters, their backgrounds, and their differences. It touches on themes of traditionalism, curses, superstition, possession, and insanity, among others. Yet, despite its relatively hefty runtime and its myriad number of characters, it never feels overly long. The film is expansive in the scope of its setting, cast, and themes, but it maintains the claustrophobic atmosphere one might look for in the found footage genre.
The key here is control. All throughout Noroi, Shiraishi and Yokota demonstrate the firm grasp they maintain of how to make a solid horror film and how to control their audience. The scares don't come quick and loose in Noroi, with the filmmakers instead building tension, priming the audience for spooks, then subverting their expectations. On the very rare occasion in which a jump scare is followed through, it never feels cheap. Instead, it feels earned.
Noroi is not, in this way, a lazy horror film, and it's not for the lazy viewer. But it also expertly walks the line between feeling natural and being smart, teaching the viewer how to understand it. A lazy horror film will tell its audience how to feel. Noroi, by contrast, implants images and parallels through suggestion and subtlety, allowing the audience to scare themselves. Shiraishi understands that a person's mind is their own worst enemy when it comes to horror. He shows through how he controls us and our level of tension that we hold the power to scare ourselves, and that the film is merely suggesting that we do so.
Before you run off and watch the film, there's one thing that might help you understand it better. For the most part, you won't need any cultural background information, and we definitely don't want to spoil anything. This is why we've foregone even a basic synopsis this time. But there was one little bit that left us scratching our heads after viewing this film. As it turns out, in Shinto, the traditional religion of Japan, birds can represent many, many things. As we discussed this in the Bakumatsu Taioden episode, in how a crow led Jimmu, the first legendary emperor, during his pilgrimage across the country, in Noroi, you might be interested to know that birds can be seen as harbingers of death, or that they can represent disembodied human spirits. So when some of our feathered friends make an appearance, bear this in mind. Otherwise, cultural backgrounds shouldn't impede anyone's travels through the film.
Overall, Noroi presents a very lo-fi type of horror. It seems like the type of thing that was completed on a relatively small budget, given the limited number of effects which are used throughout. It's essentially what the best type of found footage film looks like. In other words, it's what one could hope for in the film equivalent of creepypasta or ashcan horror, the way it lures you in with its sense of reality, then spooks you. Shiraishi and his crew didn't need a multi-million dollar budget and CGI-laden scenes of monsters bursting forth from the void to shake us to our core. He only needed an audience to whom he could tell a story. And that's why we're recommending this as our Halloween pick for 2017. Check Noroi out and let us know what you think. And please, don't watch it alone. Not because we doubt your iron will, but because this is the type of film worth sharing. It's so heavily textured and full of foreshadowing that will likely be missed the first time around that it demands to be discussed. We certainly won't forget this one anytime soon, and we're hoping you won't either.